Now, this is the sphenoid bone, kind of outlining it right here. It's going to be found right in the middle of the cranial cavity. You can see it runs on the anterior side up here. We have the frontal bone. You can see a little bit of the ethmoid bone coming down. And then down here, we have the occipital bone and the temporal bone here and temporal bone there. So you can see that the sphenoid bone is right in the very middle. As far as landmarks go, we have the sphenoidal sinus inside. Again, the plastic mold, you can't quite see it, but you know it's inside the sphenoid bone. You then have the sella turcica. This indent right here, right where the probe is, that indent is the sella turcica. Now you can see how it's protected by bone on the inferior as well as the anterior and posterior sides. The structure that goes in there, that's the pituitary gland, nice and protected via bone. If we look up top here, so more of the superior aspect, we have this little ridge and this little ridge. Those are referred to as the lesser wings. So we have this ridge and this ridge. Now, if we go more inferior or below, right here and down here, those are referred to as the greater wings. So they're larger and more inferior, the greater wings, right here and here. From this view, you can see these little openings here and here. Those openings are going to go right into the eye orbit. Those are your optic foramen or optic canals. Then from this view, we can see four different foramen present. The most medial of these four is this one right here, the foramen lacerum. The foramen lacerum is going to be just lateral, each side, of the sella turcica. It's the foramen lacerum. Moving a little more lateral, you end up with this one, which is the foramen ovale. The foramen ovale then moves out to the foramen spinosum. And it's the same on both sides. So you have the foramen lacerum, foramen ovale, foramen spinosum. The fourth one I point to, which is up here, that is going to be your foramen rotundum. So you can see on this side, you can also see it on this side, the foramen rotundum. So we have a series of foramen, or canals, the holes, in the sphenoid bone. We have the optic foramen, the foramen rotundum, foramen lacerum, foramen ovale, foramen spinosum. Now if we move the orientation, just looking at it from the anterior side, to the front of the face, you can see that we do have, one more turn there, the optic foramen right back in there. It's a small round hole on the most medial side or medial aspect of the eye orbit. That would go right through and come out the other side, which we just saw previously. Also in the eye, we're going to have the superior orbital fissure. Now the superior orbital fissure is this slit right up here. That slit will come through to the back right into the actual skull. So we have the superior orbital fissure is the top or upper of the two little slits. The optic foramen is the round hole. To go back inside the skull and try to see its orientation, you can see that this is going to be the superior orbital fissure. With orientation-wise, this is going to be your foramen rotundum. And then, because this is three-dimensional, we can see the inside, we can see the anterior, we can also flip the skull upside down and look underneath. Underneath the skull, we're going to have this still being part of the sphenoid bone. And this is your pterygoid process. Now, technically it starts with a P, but the P is silent, so the pterygoid process is on each side on the inferior portion of the skull. And in this view, you can also see some of the foramen. Let's see if I can get this oriented. So here's your foramen magnum. Then with the foramen lacerum, foramen ovale, and the foramen spinosum is right there. So you can see three of the foramen from this inferior view.